All right, I'm going to show you how to properly bleed a 700 Rhino. First, you want to jack up the front end as high as you can get it. That way the radiator is higher than the motor. Then you want to fill up the radiator to the top with everything sealed up. Then you want to come around to this side here. Take this bleeder screw here. Probably can't hear the air on there, but we can hear it. You don't want to take it all the way out. Just take it out there to where you can wiggle. Right, once you do that, screw it back in there some, then you have to go back to the radiator. We had it full just a minute ago. Fill it again. It's all the way empty just from me filling. I had it all the way full. Right, there it is, all the way full again. We'll go do the same thing. Feel the air hitting my hand. Alright. I'm gonna do it again. That's how much air they hold in. Fill the radiator again. Leave that just a little bit loose till I fill it all the way up again. Leave this one more time. One more. Make sure this is still full. It is. Then you got one more on the top of the water pump right here. And this one has to be done where it'll have an air pocket in the water pump. This one's a little hard to get to and try to keep it from falling out too, but you want to make sure. And there it was, you heard it. That was the
air pocket and water pump. And it won't pump good with that, just that one spot right there, that air pocket in there.
Now that you've bled both spots, then come up here. Fill it up. It's not bubbling any because all the air is out. It won't sit there and bubble. Cap it off. Never run it with that open. If you run it with that open, the first thing that happens, antifreeze starts expanding and it starts coming out. You do not have to run them to bleed them, and you're not supposed to. Hope this helps. Thanks. Alright, we've bled the water. Now, it's a new build. You want to do this screw right here on the top of your oil line. You loosen it up, take the spark plug out, and turn the motor over until you get oil here, and then you've bled the oil system too. Then I put the screw back tight, I leave the plug out, and I crank it over, 8 or 10 seconds at a time, 3 or 4 cycles, and that way I know I got oil through the motor. And now it's ready to fire up and pump's new motor. And we don't know what the map is or nothing for this one yet, so it should be close with his old one for idling anyway. See what happens.
Radiator hose, I let